Welcome back, my dear students. For last few classes, we have discussed about our second chapter, motion. And in the last class, I had given you to complete a table. Did you complete that? Okay, I will explain it. Based on this figure, let's try to complete the table. And one more point I need to add, that suppose the time taken to travel to the office and back home is 600 seconds. On reaching office, the total distance traveled. Look at this figure. The total distance traveled is 900 meter. So 900 meter is the total distance traveled on reaching to office. Next is displacement. We know displacement is the shortest straight line distance between initial and final point. Home is the initial point and office is the final point. So the straight line distance between them is 480 meter. And we know the time for the journey is 600 seconds. Look at this. To travel 900 meter, it takes 600 seconds. The distance traveled per second. The distance traveled in 1 second, 900 divided by 600. Cancelling each other, 1.5 is the answer. Here we have divided distance to time. So the unit become meter per second. So the answer is 1.5 meter per second. Next is the displacement per second. Look at this table. The displacement is 480 meter. So 480 divided by 600. So 480 divided by 600. That is equal to 0.8 meter per second. Next is, on reaching back home, the total distance traveled is 900 plus 1080, that is equal to 1980 meter. The displacement. We know the initial and final point are same. So the displacement be 0. While calculating time, let's consider two situations. On reaching office, he has taken 600 seconds. And on reaching back home, again 600 seconds. So 600 plus 600, 1200 second. Next is distance traveled per second. That is, to travel 1980 meter, it takes 1200 seconds. So for 1 second, 1980 meter divided by 1200 second. That is equal to 1.65 meter per second. Coming to displacement. The displacement per second. We know on reaching home, the initial and final point are same. So displacement equal to 0. That means 0 divided by 1200 second. That is equal to 0. Excess speed and careless driving are the two major reasons for accidents. Do you know what excess speed is? Now you got an idea. Speed is the distance traveled in unit time. That is, speed equal to distance by time. Velocity is the displacement in unit time. That is, velocity equal to displacement divided by time. We know displacement is the straight line distance from initial position to the final position. We didn't consider the path taken. Like that, while calculating velocity, this straight line distance itself is the displacement. Even it is not the actual path taken, we have taken only the straight line distance. Thus, we can say speed is a scalar quantity and velocity is a vector quantity. Let's look an example. An object moves A to C through B. Find speed and velocity. The object moves A to C through B. So we have to find the speed and velocity. Speed equal to distance divided by time. So the distance from A to C equal to 60 plus 40. And the time taken for the journey is 6 plus 4. That is equal to 100 divided by 10. Cancelling each other, we got 10. Then we have to find the unit. The unit of distance is meter. And the unit of time is second. So the unit of speed equal to meter per second. The unit of speed is obtained from two fundamental quantities, distance and time. So, speed is a derived unit. Study well. Next, we are going to find the velocity. Velocity equal to displacement by time. Displacement is the straight line distance between initial and final point. A is the initial point and C is the final point. So, the straight line distance between them equal to 70 meter. So, 70 divided by 6 plus 4, 10. That is equal to 7 meter per second. The unit of speed and velocity are same. Both have the unit meter per second.